Good morning. How is everyone doing this morning? I'm fine. I'm doing really well. My name is Reverend Ron Card, and we are now on Facebook Live. Yes, yay! And I would like to welcome everyone on behalf of the Center for Spiritual Living, Carlsbad, in Carlsbad, California. Great place to be. Little overcast this morning, but we're really close to the beach, and I'm here in Oceanside. I'm in my dining room, and I'm sitting here talking to you on Facebook Live. You know, this morning it is my honor to give the Sunday morning message, and I really miss doing this at church. I really miss seeing all of you, and I can't wait till we are all together again. You know, I so much would like to be at the podium looking out at you and seeing your smiling faces. But I do want you to know that you are all in my heart, you're in my prayers, and I hope everything is going well for all of you. Our May theme is to listen to your heart. Yes, to listen to that heart. And the name of my talk this morning is what voice are you listening to? Because there's two voices that we listen to. The one voice that we listen to is a voice that we listen to from the heart, known as our intuition. And then there's another voice that we listen to, and that is the voice that we use in our head. And that's more of the critical voice. And so my question would be, which voice are you listening to? There's an old Cherokee who is teaching his grandson about life. And he says, a fight is going on inside me. It's a terrible fight, and it's between two wolves. One is evil, anger, sorrow, regret, greed, arrogance, self-pity, resentment, lies, false pride, guilt, and ego. And then as he continues, he said, the other one is good, is joy, peace, love, hope, kindness, generosity, truth, compassion, and faith. And then he looked at his grandson and he said, the same fight is going on inside you and inside every other person. And the grandson, he thought about it for a moment. And then he asked his grandfather, which wolf will win? And the old Cherokee just simply replied, the one that you feed. So, which one are we feeding? I know the one I want to feed. I want to feed the love and the compassion. You know, many of you have been told, just like me, to listen to your heart, to listen to that inner voice. And you probably already know what I'm talking about because we've heard this many different ways from many different people. And there are many different phrases that we use, such as follow your heart. And then another is always listen to your heart because it is always right. And then as I was on the internet, kind of looking around for things to talk about, to put together my talk, I found this one. I thought this was really interesting. And it says, your heart knows things that your mind can't explain. So when you listen to your heart, it's all about feelings. It's about opening those feelings, sensing those feelings. But since we are talking about feelings, let's just kind of take this maybe one step deeper. You know, how many times in a moment of panic or maybe extreme frustration have you uttered to yourself, I hate you. I can't stand you. I can't stand to look at you or be around you. You know, just like the Cherokee said, which one do you feed? So my question now becomes, how do you know the difference between mind chatter, you know, that ego, when we take it from the head, or that quiet, soft voice within? Spirit speaking to us, the heart speaking to us. The thing is, many of us don't know. So we keep falling on our face because we mistake the ego for that inner voice. You know, the ego is very, very good at imitating that inner voice. But the key is to keep listening again and again for that soft voice. Just become quiet. Just notice. Just become aware of what you are thinking, what you are feeling. You know, Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson, they decide to go on a camping trip. And after dinner and a bottle of wine, they lay down for the night and go to sleep. And some hours later, Dr. Holmes, he awoke and he kind of nudged his faithful friend, Watson. "Watson, look up at the sky. Tell me what you see." And Watson replied, "I see millions of stars." "Well, Watson, what does that really tell you?" And Watson, he kind of pondered for a minute. He says, "It tells me that there are millions of galaxies and potentially billions of planets. And as I observe this, I see that Saturn is in Leo. And I deduce that the time is 3:15. And I can see that God is all powerful and that we are small and insignificant. And I suspect that we will all have a beautiful day tomorrow." And he looked at Holmes. "Well, what does that tell you, Holmes?" And Holmes was silent for a minute. Then he spoke. "Watson, you idiot, someone has stolen our tent." Well, what this tells me is we need to listen. We need to be observant. We need to know. This is why it's so important to just listen, to become quiet, to just notice and become aware of our thinking and what you are feeling. When we're in times of adversities, or we're in conversation, or we're thinking, we need to be present. We need to be aware. Which wolf are we feeding? That voice within is your inner guidance system. It is your spiritual center speaking. This inner voice speaks to you through many means of communication, many different ways. You know, have you ever had a situation in your life when you suddenly decided that you should take a different road on the way home? I've had this many times. You know, you only find out later that the original road that you usually travel on was a scene of a car crash or a major tie-up. You know, have you ever had a thought to not do something and ignore that thought that you should have had actually paid attention to because something negative happened? You know, you ignore that inner voice and you paid the consequences. You know, I have certainly learned my lesson many times for not listening to this voice. I had ideas come to mind, ideas and things I needed to do come to mind, and you know what? I didn't pay attention to that. And then I seen other people with these ideas, with these things that I had thought of. You know, I say to myself, "Where's my V8? You know, I mean, I should have been paying attention. You know, this small, soft voice from within is a subtle voice, and it communicates through our thoughts, it communicates through our feelings, and even our environment. And sometimes you can recognize it very easily, especially when you find that you are having the same thought over and over and over again about a certain situation. That's a key in telling you something is here. You need to look at something. You need to feel this. You know, while doing the research for my talk, I ran across a story on the internet. And this is a story about really listening to that inner inner voice, listening to your heart. You know, a far more personal moment came when my inner voice told me to do something and I didn't listen. It was the night before my brother's third heart surgery when I visited him in the hospital. And after a walk down the hall and light talking about our children, it was time to leave. And as I saw him lying in a hospital bed, I had this overwhelming urge to give him a hug, to tell him I loved him, and wish him good luck. You know, that kind of emotional display was really out of the character for us. But as I thought, it might tell him that maybe I'm a little worried about him. So I didn't. I didn't tell him. I didn't hug him. And my brother didn't survive the surgery. And as I look back, I know that most of the mistakes that I have come to in my life was not listening to myself, when I didn't really trust my instincts. You know, there's so much coming at us every day that life can get very confusing. But as I have always told my children, there is only one person with whom you go to bed with every night and get up with every morning, and that is you. But sometimes you have to stop paying attention to yourself, because I believe that you need to listen. You need to listen from within. You need to listen from the heart carefully to hear your inner voice, and then you have to do what it says. That's the other half of listening to that small voice within. You know, as I have mentioned before, we are thinking beings. We're thinking constantly. It's really hard to stop your thinking. But we are either thinking out loud with our words, like what I'm doing right here, right now, or we are silently thinking and speaking silently in our thoughts. You know, that mind chatter, or listening from the heart. When you hear voices such as, you're stupid, or you're not attractive, you're not like other people, or maybe you've heard you will never be successful, or no one appreciates your hard work, or you say to yourself, you know, he doesn't care about me, or you're better off on your own. But this is not the type of talk that I'm talking about that comes from the heart, that soft voice within. This is why it's so important to step back, to take a deep breath, to see and feel what you are saying and thinking to yourself, and realize that you are more than this. You are a spiritual being. You are whole. You are perfect. You are complete. You are more powerful than you can even imagine. Now, this is not the kind of inner voice I'm talking about when you hear that inner voice from the heart. This is nothing more than your critical inner voice, that chatter that's in the mind. Your critical inner voice comes from very early life experiences, you know, negative attitudes that we may have experienced, and how we see and how we feel, not only about ourselves, but about different people and different situations. Again, you really have to kind of step back and say, which wolf are you feeding? You know, in the Science of Mind textbook on page 342, our founder, Dr. Ernest Holmes, what he states is, the intelligence in an animal which directs its actions and tells it where to find food and shelter, we call this instinct. And the same quality, more highly developed, makes a conscious appearance in man, and is what we call intuition. Intuition is God in man. It's that voice we hear here, revealing to him the realities of being. And just like instinct guides the animal, so would intuition guide man, if he would only allow it to do so. What I have learned in this teaching of science of mind is that that soft voice within, that soft voice from the heart, the one we need to pay attention to, is that intuition in man that Dr. Holmes is talking about. Now, I'm sure we have all had those moments when we felt a warning sign in our gut or a warning sign in our heart. You know, we may have had sweaty palms walking into situations that we don't feel good about. You know, these signals from your intuition are very important, and we need to pay attention. We need to pay attention to these warning signs. While it may seem simple and obvious to many, that we need to really heed these. You know, we have moved into relationships with the wrong person, eating food in a restaurant that made us sick, and maybe even shared something with the wrong person. I want to kind of share another short story. Actually, there's two of them. I found these on the internet that I think really speak to us. And one is by Pam, and another one is by John. So we'll do Pam first. You know, I was sitting in a coffee shop, busy writing a book, and a friend called me to see if she could meet me at my house in a half hour. And I started to say yes out of obligation, and then I realized I was really shortchanging myself because I really didn't want, I wanted to stay where I was. I got this funny feeling in my throat, and I started having a gut ache until I told the truth that I was in the middle of writing and I needed just a little bit more time. And I trusted my intuition. And what happened is it turned out that she also could have used the extra time. You know, how many of you have experienced that? You know, I had the other story with John is I had a buzzing sound in my head one time when I was about ready to get on the freeway. You know, and as I listened to it more carefully, I heard an inner sound that reminded me of a siren of an ambulance. And so I decided not to take the freeway. I took the city streets instead. And what I did is I later learned that there had been an accident on the freeway and the traffic was really backed up. You know, it was a good thing that I listened to my intuition as I was on my way to an important meeting. So we have to remember, pay attention to your intuitive signals. That's why we need to step back and slow down and feel. You know, as I come to the close of my talk, the question that I first asked was, what voice are you listening to? You know, I want to listen to the voice from my heart. I want to listen to my intuition. You know, it's a voice of compassion, of joy, of hope, of peace, of love, of good. You know, these are the things I want to see unfold in my life. This is how I want people to see me. I want to be able to attract things into my life that I desire and that I want. And you do it not by pushing it away, not by thinking negative, by listening to your heart and putting out those positive things. You know, the other voice, you know that critical inner voice? It's a well-integrated pattern of destructive thoughts towards ourselves and towards others. We must remember the critical inner voice is that internal enemy that can affect every aspect of not only our lives, but all those around us, including our self-esteem and our confidence, our relationship, not only with ourselves, but with others, and our accomplishments, things that we want to accomplish in life. Remember, your thoughts and your words are seeds. We plant them in mind. And whichever wolf, whichever seed you feed, whichever you put into mind, it will unfold in the experiences and the conditions of your life. Do you want to see your life positive and happy and successful? Or do you want just the opposite? The choice is yours. Which wolf are you feeding? You know, before I close, you know, please join me also on Wednesday evening at 7 o'clock. I do a small 10-minute talk, and I call this Midweek Booth with Rev Ron. Kind of catchy, huh? But this week, I'm going to be speaking on, are you ready to receive? So if you got things that you want to attract in your life, well then, tune in. Because we can take a look at those possibilities. I can show you how to open up your possibilities so these may happen. So again, thank you and have a good week.